Metric versus imperial is a YouTube minefield. If we do our videos in metric only, we get trolled by American bros. Meters are for the weak. And if we do our videos in imperial units only, we get trolled by everyone else. So on behalf of all Americans, I'm here to tell you it's not our fault that we haven't fully adopted the metric system. If you want to blame someone, you gotta blame pirates.
Let's find out why.
Welcome to the Y-Files, where smart folks like us get together to talk nerdy. Today we're trying to answer the question, why doesn't the US use the metric system? Well, one reason is pirates.
Like from Pittsburgh?
No, actual pirates.
Peg legs and pirates and eye patch pirates?
Yep. Here's what happened. In 1793, the United States was brand spanking new, and it needed standards for weights and measures. And each state was kind of doing its own thing. New York had a Dutch system. Other states were using measurements based on English units, little France in there, little Spain. Interstate commerce was a mess. The Secretary of State at this time was Thomas Jefferson, who spent a lot of time in France. He was a Francophile, and France was in the middle of their own revolution and was implementing a new decimal-based system of weights and measures. This intrigued Thomas Jefferson, so he said, bring us some of that. So French scientist Joseph Dombey was dispatched to the US with two objects, a 1 kilogram copper weight called a grave and a 1 meter scale. Dombey was on his way to Philadelphia when his ship hit a storm and blew it a little too far south. He ended up in the Caribbean. And you know who's hanging out in the Caribbean in the 18th century? Pirates, that's who. Technically, they weren't pirates, they were privateers.
What's the difference?
Well, privateers are sanctioned by a government and are legally allowed to attack and harass and even steal enemy ships.
Oh, nice work if you can get it.
It is. In this case, British pirateers intercepted Dombey's ship, stole the metric doodads, and threw him in prison in Montserrat, hoping to hold him for ransom.
Okay.
He died in prison.
Oh no, and the doodads?
Sold at auction.
Ooh, tough break.
But why is the rum gone?
By the mid-1800s, the US was pretty well settled on what's called the US customary system, which is based on UK's imperial system, but we kept trying. In 1866, Congress authorized the use of the metric system and supplied each state with their own set of metric weights and measures. People didn't like it.
What's the problem?
Well, the US system was, and some argue still is, just more accessible and relatable. A foot is about the length of your foot, an inch is about the width of your thumb. It's tangible and it's been consistent. Today's kilogram is not exactly the same weight as that copper doodad back from 1793. It's changed a little bit. And in the 19th century, with all the political upheaval and turmoil around the world, metric units fluctuated a little bit. And some countries just went off the metric system altogether and then came back later. Meanwhile, the US, during all that time, stayed consistent. Now, we kept trying. In 1875, the United States signed the Meter Convention, which was an international treaty that created a system of metric standards. But American industry pushed back.
The Illuminati?
Not quite. Powerful industrialists argued that switching to metric would be too expensive and that American infrastructure would be harmed, so they resisted.
The Illuminati!
Still, in 1893, all measurements in the United States were defined by this international standard. So officially, in the US, a yard is not defined as 3 feet or 36 inches. A yard is 0.9144 meters. Pounds, inches, miles, they're all defined by their metric equivalents. By the mid-20th century, the world's economy was becoming more and more globalized. And if you wanted to do business internationally, you had to do metric. The reason the UK switched in 1965 was because they wanted access to more European markets. This is the metric symbol for moolah. The United States was also part of this trend, and in 1971, Congress recommended that the United States go metric within 10 years.
Yeah, how did that work out?
It didn't. The Metric Conversion Act of 1975 encouraged the use of metric, but didn't require it, so Americans kept doing what they were doing. But big business in America did see the value in going metric. They were saving millions of dollars. So big companies like Xerox, GM, IBM, Ford, they all switched to metric long before 1975. And most big American companies followed suit. The American scientific community also saw benefits to switching, especially after NASA crashed the Mars Climate Orbiter into the Martian atmosphere because the thrusters on the orbiter were being measured in metric newtons, but ground control was still using pounds. So that was years of work and $125 million vaporized because they didn't use metric.
And this was the 70s?
Oh, this was 1999.
Oh, come on, NASA. Get it together, you eggheads.
Now, it wasn't all NASA's fault. You can also blame the engineers at Lockheed Martin.
Illuminati!
Will you stop with that? There is no Illuminati.
Oh, you silly, simple bastard.
Now, Congress tried again with the Omnibus Foreign Trade Act in 1988. It didn't take. The Savings and Construction Act of 1996? Nope. The High-End Computing and Revitalization Act of 2004? Still no joy for metric.
Millimeters and kilograms.
What metric needed in America was a champion. A forward-looking leader who can take the country into the 21st century. And during the 2016 presidential campaign, a champion emerged with a bold vision for having the United States join the world by implementing metric. That champion was Lincoln Chaffee.
Oh?
Lincoln Chaffee?
It sounds like the name of a car. Is this a person?
Former senator, former governor of Rhode Island, presidential candidate, Lincoln Chaffee.
Yeah, it doesn't ring a bell.
Right. Here's why. Against the advice of his family, his advisors, Lincoln Chaffee made going metric a core part of his presidential platform.
Earlier, I said, let's be bold. Here's a bold embrace of internationalism. Let's join the rest of the world and go metric.
Let me guess.
Lincoln Chaffee, he'll be out of this race in 0.2 nanoseconds.
Oof, ah.
Technically, America is a metric country. All federal agencies are required to use metric. All consumer and food products are required to have metric on the packaging and use metric in manufacturing. So we're getting there slowly. It's just gonna take a little time.
Inch by inch, baby!
Really?
Hey, it was either me or somebody in the comment section.
Thanks for hanging out with us today. My name is AJ, that's Hecklefish. This has been the Y-Files. Metric, what do you think? Should we keep doing both or should we switch the channel completely to metric? Let us know in the comment section. We're working hard for you, so do us a favor, hit that thumbs up, and if we haven't earned your subscription today, I promise we'll keep making fun, brainy content until we do earn it. Until next time, be safe, be kind, and know that you are appreciated.
What are you waiting for? I got nothing.